Hello everyone. Thank you very much for joining us today to hear Arvind and I talk about eddy current braking systems and how to study and simulate such problem using EMS for SolidWorks product. Firstly, let me introduce ourselves. My name is Cal and I am working as an account manager for EMWorks for almost 3 years. I primarily handle commercial sales for our company. My colleague Arvind works as a director of product management and is also an expert user of EMS product. He will be doing the technical part of today's webinar. Feel free to write down our details to email us afterwards for any inquiries. You can also connect with us over LinkedIn. Moving on to the agenda of today's presentation. We will be shortly discussing about our products, applications of eddy current braking systems, before moving on to the simulation part of this webinar. At the end, I will talk about various packages of EMS product and learning resources available. To find more details of EMS product and other products offered by EMWorks. EMWorks offers 3D and 2D electromagnetic simulation software available as an add-in tools for SolidWorks 3D CAD and Autodesk Inventor 3D CAD. We offer 4 products covering a wide range of applications. Our first flagship product is called EMS, which can be used for electric and magnetic field modeling for DC to medium frequency applications. That is from DC to around 200 megahertz. It covers many applications like cables, insulators, bus bars, permanent magnets, eddy current braking, solenoids, transformers, and electrical machines. Our second flagship product is called HFWorks, which is used for electromagnetic simulation of RF, microwave, high frequency, and high speed electrical and electronic devices. It covers applications like antennas, waveguides, filters, connectors, resonators, etc. Our third product is called EMWorks 2D, which offers 2D static analysis and covers simulation of planar and axisymmetric geometries. Our latest addition is Motor Wizard software, which is a template-based motor design software. It offers analytical and finite element analysis of BLDC motors. In addition to these products, we offer various multi-physics add-ons like thermal, motion, linear statics, and circuits. And today's webinar will focus on our first flagship product, which is EMS for SolidWorks. EMWorks offers 3 different programs: commercial, academic, and startup. Each program has its own requirements and benefits. Within commercial program, we offer perpetual licenses, while in the rest of the programs, our licensing structure is usually annual based. The topic of our today's webinar is simulating eddy current braking systems using EMS for SolidWorks. Through this demo, we will see how to set up eddy current braking simulation, coupling EMS software with SolidWorks motion analysis using our own motion add-on, and visualizing various plots to understand the behavior of the system. Before going forward, let us quickly understand the industries where eddy current braking is utilized. Transit systems. Eddy current braking is a remarkable option for transit systems because of its low cost of maintenance and resistance to harsh weather conditions. They are a safe way to de-accelerate a moving train while providing constant comfort and ease for passengers. Roller coasters. Extreme uses for the eddy current brakes can be seen in amusement parks and entertainment centers all over. Whether this is in roller coasters or other rides, braking technology is vital to amusement parks around the world. Power tools and large industrial machinery use the eddy current braking technology for several applications. One of the main uses is in emergency shutoff. Power tools have concerns with safety, which makes the emergency shutoff a must-have feature. If a power tool such as saw or drill are shut off, the eddy currents kick in and safely bring the machine to a halt.
Now, let's talk about signals.
Gym equipments. Exercise equipment utilizes its technology in many ways.
Same antenna can receive and transmit.
I would kindly request the turn off the kindly mute your microphones.
That is when teaches us to look for patterns and make connections during trend analysis.
Thank you. To everyone, please kindly mute your microphones just to avoid any kind of background noise while we are doing this presentation. Thank you very much. So I was talking about industry and now coming to the gym equipment. So exercise equipment utilizes this technology in many ways. Modern workout machines uses eddy currents to create smooth transition between resistance levels and make for low maintenance machinery. Recreation equipment. Eddy current braking systems are frequently used in recreation equipments. Eddy current braking is used in auto belay to safely assist climbers in their descent from the top. So let us now move to the technical part of this webinar. Quick notes before we begin. Please mute your microphones to avoid any background noise. You can use the GoToMeeting chat window to type in your questions and we will answer them at the end of this presentation. A webinar recording will be sent to all the registrants in a few days. Now I would like to request my colleague Arvind, who will be doing the next part of this presentation.
Thank you, Kalyan, and good afternoon to everybody. My name is Arvind, and as my colleague introduced this topic to you, I will be happy to tackle the technical section of this webinar. For those of us who are joining in, welcome again. And recording to this webinar will be sent to you and to all the participants and registrants. So feel free to share it with your colleagues. And also at the end of this webinar, we will have a Q&A session. So feel free to type in your questions in the GoToMeeting chat window. Okay. Now, let me begin this webinar by going over the technical part of the webinar by going over two separate classes of problems in eddy current braking. One class of problem deals with rotary type of braking. Now we have systems like machineries, etc., where there is going to be rotational motion. And if you need to decelerate or to stop this rotation motion, rotary eddy current braking systems are widely employed. I will show you a demonstration of a typical system where we use a combination of magnets to stop a conductor which is rotating. Okay. So in this first example, our objectives are going to be to first see how the angular velocity drops as a function of time. So basically we have something rotating at a particular speed, a disc, and then when a set of magnets are brought into its vicinity, the disc decelerates and the engineer is interested in computing how long it takes for the disc to stop or largely reduce its velocity, rotational velocity. Next, we will take a look at what kind of opposing torque is being produced to bring about this drop in the speed of the rotating disc. And finally, the EMS product allows you to visualize the magnitude of these eddy currents. And the magnitude of these eddy currents tell you about the efficacy with which the braking happens. It also gives you an idea about what kind of heat could be potentially generated in this conductor due to the eddy current braking. Granted that eddy current braking systems are frictionless and they are contactless braking, and hence offer a lot of advantages, as my colleague earlier mentioned, there will nevertheless be some amount of heat dissipated because of the eddy currents that are set up in the conductor. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my SolidWorks screen with you, and I'm going to show you how eddy current braking systems are done in EMS and SolidWorks. Now, what you see here is a rotary disc. Now, this rotary disc rotates with a certain RPM, for example, 6000 degrees per second. And this rotary disc, if you want to stop this rotary disc, we also have an arrangement of magnets that you see here. These are permanent magnets, and they are brought in the vicinity of the rotating disc. So because there is a time varying change in the magnetic field experienced due to the rotation motion, eddy currents will be set up in this rotating disc. Now, this eddy current is responsible for slowing down the disc. Let us see how we can use EMS to do this simulation. Okay. Now, first of all, EMS is an add-in product inside SolidWorks. So what does it mean? It means that you don't have to ever leave the SolidWorks environment to do your simulation. If you install EMS, you're going to get an EMS manager tab, and here is where you will organize your simulations. Now, eddy current braking systems are inherently a combination of electromagnetics and a motion simulation. So you can call these classes of problems as multiphysics problems. And the motion solver that we will be using for eddy current braking simulation, and the natural solver of choice for EMS products, is going to be SolidWorks Motion. So here in this demonstration, you're going to see both SolidWorks CAD, EMS, and SolidWorks Motion in action. So the first step that is really needed in doing any kind of EM simulation is basically to create what is called as a study. So when you create a study in EMS, we have several different study options. For eddy current problems, they're inherently transient in nature. What do I mean by transient is that the magnetic field and all the quantities vary as a function of time. So your solver of choice will be transient magnetic. Also, eddy current braking involves coupling to motion, and so EMS allows you to couple this simulation to SolidWorks Motion. Once you create a simulation study, you're going to get a study tree as you see here. Now, the first step involved is to apply materials to various components. Now, here the back iron is made of mild steel material. And to apply a material in EMS, it's very easy. You just right click on the material and select apply materials. EMS product comes with a natural inbuilt database of numerous materials. Basically, they are organized into various categories, and most of the materials that are used by electrical and magnetic engineers are available in the EMS material library. EMS material library is also a fully customizable library, so you can create your own materials and use them for simulation. Now, the moving disc is made of a nice conductor material. In this case, we have a copper disc, so it's made of copper. And all the permanent magnets here, they are made of neodymium magnets. So you can go ahead and take a look at our magnet library. We have a library of permanent magnets, again arranged whether they are Alnico based, ceramic, neodymium, or samarium cobalt. Now, once you define these materials, I'm going to zoom in, and this is where the magnet directions are established. So EMS provides a very easy way for users to define the direction of the magnet. So when you look at coercivity direction, EMS allows you to set up the direction of the magnet either in the global coordinate system or in the local coordinate system. So here you can see these magnets have coercivity directions that are alternating. So two adjacent magnets have opposite directions, which actually creates local recirculation of magnetic fields, and it's very effective in applying a uniform braking torque to the spinning disc. Once the materials are defined, let us now see what kind of motion shall we give to this particular disc. As I mentioned earlier, the disc is moving initially with a constant speed, and that can be set in SolidWorks Motion by imparting a move initial velocity to the moving disc. So you can look at the moving disc and it's imparted an initial velocity. Next, we also will have a braking torque, and that is done in EMS, where EMS can calculate the braking torque at the center of the moving disc, and this braking torque is coupled to SolidWorks Motion, and this acts as the torque responsible for slowing down the disc. With this, the definition of the problem is completed. And finally, we will have to tell the program how long you want to do the simulation. For example, we would like to study the motion of the disc for, say, 200 milliseconds. And that's where we tell the motion simulation the total time duration for this transient simulation. So prior to this webinar, I solved this problem, and now we can take a look directly at the results. What are the results that are interesting to us? Now it makes sense to go back to our objectives. The first objective that we have is, how does the angular velocity of the disc behave as a function of time? As you notice here, the angular velocity starts at 6,000 degrees per second. And within 60 milliseconds, it reaches a value of zero. So basically, this braking system is able to bring the copper disc rotating at 6,000 degrees per second to a stop in less than 60 milliseconds. And you can see how effective this is when compared to your operating specs or your requirements for this product. So EMS helps you to get the time needed for your disc to stop. Now these values are available, and they can be exported as a text file or an Excel file for further processing. The next objective is really for us to study the torque about the z-axis. So EMS helps you to understand how the torque varies as a function of time. Now this is the braking torque. You see the negative value is really opposing the movement, and you can see how the braking torque varies as a function of time. Last but not the least, EMS also has the ability to view the eddy currents. Now here I have a plot of an eddy current distribution in the copper disc at a particular time, say 80 milliseconds. One can actually plot these eddy currents, and you can also animate the movement of the disc as a function of time. So here I'm going to create an animation where the eddy currents will change as the disc starts to rotate. Notice how the changes happen in the magnitude and the direction and the eddy currents in the rotating disc. So as soon as the disc comes to a stop, the value of the eddy currents really goes down. So you can see how the eddy currents propagate and change as a function of time. Let me stop the animation here. So as a recap, so we were able to use the rotatory eddy current breaking example that I showed you to understand how effectively your braking system stops the rotary disc. Next, we will move on to another problem, in this case, a linear eddy current system. Thank you, Kalyan. Now, in this second demonstration, I'm going to show you another type of motion which can be used for eddy current braking. That's the linear system. And linear systems are also quite useful, and they are widely used, for example, in the case of roller coasters or in transit systems where things move linearly and you want to stop them. Okay. The objectives of this particular demonstration is not too different than the previous one. Instead of finding the angular velocity, we would like to know how the linear velocity varies as a function of time. Just like how we plotted torque as a function of time, here we will plot the retarding force as a function of time. And finally, we can always visualize the eddy current. So let me again go back to my SolidWorks and show you a linear eddy current braking system. So I'm going to close this model. So that we go to a model that comprises a linear eddy current braking system. Here I have a Halbach array made up of 5 permanent magnets, and I also have a conductor material that moves linearly over the Halbach array. The objective, as we saw earlier, is really to understand what happens to the motion of this conductor as it comes in the vicinity of the magnetic field set up due to the Halbach array. Again, the way eddy currents work is whenever a moving conductor, in this case, notices a change in the magnetic flux, eddy currents are set up. And these eddy currents are set up in such a way that they oppose the source magnetic flux. And as a result, there is going to be some amount of retarding force on the moving conductor that slows down the conductor. So in this particular example, just like before, we employ a transient magnetic study and we couple that to SolidWorks motion. Let's first look at the motion study. In the motion study, we actually tell the program how long you have to run. In this case, it's going to be for 10 milliseconds. We want to see what happens to the movement in 10 milliseconds. And we also impart an initial velocity to the moving conductor. So we have an initial velocity of close to 400 inches per second to the moving conductor. You can see that that's a large enough initial velocity. And we want to see how in 10 milliseconds, what does the velocity go down to, and so on. As before, the steps involved are the same. We assign materials to the various components. In this case, the neodymium magnets are made of N38 material, and then the moving conductor is a copper conductor. And we also want to compute the force, the retarding force on the copper conductor, which is done by the electromagnetic simulation. And this force is transferred to SolidWorks motion. And as a result, the retardation of the moving conductor is accomplished using the motion simulation. Let us now go to the results in the model. The first thing we will look at is the velocity of the moving conductor. Notice that the velocity of the moving conductor actually changes from about minus 10. It's minus because it is in the negative x-axis. It's moving in the negative x-axis. And it goes all the way to minus 6. So there is some amount of loss in velocity. And this plot is actually better visualized in SolidWorks Motion. Here I'm going to plot the velocity. You can see here, we were talking in inches per second. So the velocity changes from minus 394 inches per second to minus 206 inches per second. So that's actually a drop in velocity in the negative x-axis, because if you see, the positive SolidWorks x-axis is not in the direction, but the movement of the conductor is in the negative x-axis. So it starts with an initial velocity of minus 394 inches per second. And then after 10 milliseconds, it loses velocity. And the final velocity is minus 206 inches per second. It will be interesting to see what is the retarding force. The retarding force is going to be opposite to the motion, and hence it will be in the positive x-axis. So you can see how the force varies as a function of time, reaching a maximum value of around 50 newtons. And finally, users will be able to study both the magnetic flux density as well as the current density in the model. Here is the section plot of a magnetic flux density in the model. So notice here how the magnetic flux density is distributed from the magnets throughout your model. And last but not the least, one can actually take a look at the eddy currents that are set up in the moving conductor. So you can notice here that the eddy currents, let me zoom in, and you can see the direction of the arrows that tell you that these eddy currents largely oppose the magnetic flux of the source. Okay. This is the eddy current at a particular time step, in this case after 6 milliseconds. Okay. And just as before, we will be able to animate our eddy currents as a function of time so that you can see how the eddy current value and the sense change as the conductor moves through the magnetic field. So by combining the power of a motion simulation in SolidWorks Motion and electromagnetic simulation offered by EMS, we are able to solve multiphysics problems involving complex physics in this case, electromagnetics as well as kinematics motion. And one can solve interesting applications related to eddy current breaking. So with this, let me get back to the presentation, where I'm going to quickly recap the workflow that you saw in this particular technical part of the presentation. Now, the workflow for EMS is extremely simple. Because most of you are already SolidWorks users and use SolidWorks to design your assemblies, EMS is able to do your simulation right inside your SolidWorks window. Then you need to couple EMS to SolidWorks Motion for you to be able to do multiphysics simulation involving both EMS and motion. And the kind of study that we used in EMS is EMS transient magnetic solver, which is a part of the EMS magnetic bundle. And you can couple that to SolidWorks Motion. We need to turn on the eddy currents solver in this case. And finally, we can visualize the results. We can visualize both the kinematic results, how the velocity, forces, etc. change as a function of time, as well as we can visualize the field quantities. For example, the magnetic flux density, the eddy currents that are set up in the moving conductor, etc. as a function of time. With this, I would like to turn the presentation back to my colleague Cal, who will complete the rest of the webinar. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Arvind. So just to give a quick recap, EMS has four package options: electric, magnetic, professional, and premium. In addition to these basic packages, we offer few multiphysics add-ons on top of these packages like thermal, motion, structural, and circuits. Now, in order to simulate eddy current braking systems using EMS for SolidWorks, a user would require EMS magnetic package and motion add-on. Now let's talk about various learning resources. So EMWorks offers various learning resources in the form of demo viewer section within the EMS software package. We also offer application notes, blogs, and paid training lessons. So the application notes, monthly newsletters, and the blogs you can find on our EMWorks webpage. You can also subscribe to our social media channels to check application videos, upcoming event informations, or any news related to EMWorks. Now, I would like to encourage every registrant of this webinar to try our product. In order to try our product, go to our EMWorks webpage, www.emworks.com. If you go on the support tab and click on Contact Us, you will be able to see this contact us page, which I'm showing you on the right hand of the screen. You can fill in your information and hit submit, and one of our sales representative will contact you with the trial information. Before we answer your questions, I would like to thank you all on behalf of EMWorks for participating in this webinar. Feel free to contact us to get more information on our products or try our software. Thank you very much.